Welcome back. GIMP 2.8 Dinner Suit Series. Let's have a look. Open up GIMP 2.8. File. Open. Naturally, you're going to find the image. So I'm going to scroll through my little collection and I'm going to grab suit number one. That one right there, if you can see it. There it is, right there. I'm going to now this time zoom it at 200%. Go to layers, right click, make sure add alpha channel is selected. Double click my fuzzy select tool, set it to 20. It's 15 by default right there. Now you have to have a little bit of experience with GIMP, everyone, to follow this. If you don't, watch my early versions, or should I say the beginners, how to use GIMP. This is more advanced. Okay, give it a click, delete key, click and select none. This time zoom to 800, scroll across, zoom down, double click the erase tool, use your keyboard to shrink it. You should know where that key is by now. If you don't, watch my early versions of GIMP 2.8 for beginners. That's a little bit too big, so I'll make it a little bit smaller. Yes, you can use this scale tool there as well. However, now we're just going to nice and briefly set the brush right there. I'm going to use that one. It's called Harness 050. Okay, that's the one I'm going to use. While you're doing this nice and easily, you may have to zoom in and zoom out, as you're all well aware of that, and you may have to change your brush size, the hardness or the softness of it. But I'm just going to go right around. Now this is only going to take a minute, so I don't want to bore you. So I'm going to go up to there, right up to there. Now we're going to work right around to the neckline, just underneath the chin, should I say, okay? And commence down here. There's a reason why in this video tutorial we're going to put another head in this suit. Or on the suit, whatever you want to call it. Now anyway, we're going to scroll down there and follow the mouse trail. Just about there, everyone. I don't want to bore you too much. Now you're all well aware that you must take more time doing this to get it more perfectionist. Okay, I'm just giving you a quick run how this is done. Remember, you gotta set your size hard and soft, and you gotta come in a little bit more closer in as well. So you get rid of all those light little edges right there. You may not see that. Depends how good your video card is and how much memory you have. Now, when you've done that, the big shot is now enlarging your and get rid of that head. Okay, no offense to the person, but that's what we're gonna get rid of. Scroll up there because it's a lot there. While you're just about to raise everything right there nice and easily, go down here and resize your brush lower, of course, because you're going to go right in. This is a delicate part. Don't want to get too much of that neckline out, because you can remember you're going to replace that with someone else's head in there wearing that suit. That's what this whole training's about. How do we change heads? A lot of people question me that and ask me that. How do I get rid of a face or a head? And I like that outfit someone's wearing or something like that, whatever. Or what do I look like in that outfit if I had to buy it? So once that's done, I'll just give it a bit of clean up. Oops, that'll do for me at the moment. Zoom it back down to its natural size at 100%. Double click, of course. And this time you're going to crop it, and I'm just going to go like that. Now I need all that area, so I'm going to go bang, file, now it's export as, and export it wherever you want it. Alright, and I'm just going to go into my documents there and blah blah and so on and save it. Okay, so that's part one. Hope you enjoy. Hi everyone, welcome back. GIMP 2.8. This time we're going to add to head. So when you open up GIMP 2.8, I left you off with this little image right there. This time, get yourself another image of a head, of course. You can find it online. And I'm going to use this little image. I'm going to zoom it 200. Naturally go to the layers, which is a JPEG. I'm going to add the alpha channel. I'm going to double click the fuzzy select tool and set the property at 25. Okay. Let's have a look at that. You can scale up and down there if you wish, as you all know that. Have it a click, delete it, select, none. Excellent. This time, once again, I'm going to go around the edges and clean all that up. So I'm going to go to the erase tool. That's a bit too big, as you can see. I'm going to just make it short. But the brush, I'm going to make it 25. I selected a different brush size there, 25, the softness. I'm going to go right around nice and quick for you. Remember, you need to zoom in and zoom out. If you've got good hands or good experience, you'll probably get away with it, just like I'm doing right now, if you haven't. Remember, the beginner's videos, I've shown you how to zoom in and zoom out. Otherwise, you're going to make a real mess. Oh, well, that looks fairly right. Okay, got a nice neckline there. I'm going to edit and copy that. Click that image there. I'm going to zoom this out at 200 now, because I need to have a good look at it. Edit, I'm going to paste that image. But it's a floating edge, so the floating selection, should I say. Double click it, I'm going to name it head. That's what it is, the head. Very simple. Move it, of course. I'm going to move it about, let's just say there. Select the layer tool, that's a suit tool there, and go to image, canvas size. I'm going to make that canvas a bit better, bigger. I'll go to 400 now. I hope 400 is good enough. Resize, it looks all right to me. I've got the move tool active, but now I've got this suit. I'm going to bring it down, the drop there. Make sure it's right where I want it. Yep, I'll go further down. There you go. And now the head. Bring the head where I want it. Oh, about there, I suppose. Arrow key. As you're all aware what the arrow key does. You've got a few choices now. So I'm going to actually merge them together, all right? So merge down. I'm confident there, so let's see what happens. I'm going to click that tool there. This time, I'm going to start here. I'm going to go around. There, that looks pretty neat. Okay, I'm going to go over there. You can set these nods a little bit closer in if you wish. You know, this is a real quick one. Demo, as you can see, you know, it's all to do is being confident, relax. If you're not sure, watch the beginner's videos. I'm going to go around the chin. I'm gonna get close so I can. Okay. And I like to use as many nods as I can, and then I'm gonna link it together, as you all know. Select the invert tool because I'm gonna erase a few things. Double click my eraser there, and I'm gonna erase that bit there. See. Okay. Whoa, looks good. And that little hairline there, or neckline, should I say. Looks alright. I hope I've done well. If you haven't done it right, remember you can do the anti-erase, but I'm not going to go into that now. Select none. Fantastic. Looking, you can just touch it up there a bit. Right. Touch up that there. Zoom it always in, because I want to see what 800 looks like. Ooh, a bit too much there, you see. So I'm going to make it quick and easy. Drop it. Have a little bit, get defined a bit more. Oops, a bit more edges there. Looks good there. Just a little bit more there. I'm not happy there at all at the moment. Oh, yeah, you're saying, oh, look at the colors. You know, that neckline, that this neckline. Sure, we know that. So we're going to double click that. Select that color. Beautiful. Paintbrush tool. Make sure it's nice and soft. And start giving it a bit of color. You can larger your brush slowly. Don't do it too much because you don't know where you are. Well, you're not sure where you are. Now, I've got it zoomed, I believe, at 800. So I can see where it's actually going in. Not too much, not too low. I'm going to push this on a little bit quicker for you. Remember, you must take your time if you want to do this really right. Okay, I'm just sort of scrolling down, and there's my little neckline. What I like to use now is actually the smudge tool. And, there it is there. Some smudge tool. I'm going to make it smaller. I'm going to smudge it into the edges there. See? nice and easily. Give a bit of, so it looks really tucked into that shirt. Okay. And of course the erase tool, if you've just gone a little bit here or there or somewhere, make sure you got the selection's none. And oh, there's a erase tool there again. I didn't click it off on. Gets to you that time, gimping it. Okay, let's have a look at that at 100%. Voila. There it is. A picture. Save it. Do what you like. Of course, in the next video, I can show you how to change the color. Look more human, I suppose. But that looks quite nice and neat. That's how you change your head.